Greetings, Mafia. With this particular video, I want to discuss war bonds. War bonds were openly traded on the stock market since Mexican-American War. During both world wars, war bonds were openly traded by all warring parties. For instance, Americans could buy both American or German bonds, betting against America and vice versa. After all, speculation isn't about patriotism. But how is that even possible? Weren't these countries at war? Not when it comes to market. I already mentioned Mexican-American war bonds. You can also buy war bonds issued by Confederate States of America during Civil War. It was perfectly legal. Purchase of World War I and World War II bonds was heavily pushed by the media. They were available in Austria, Hungary, Germany, United Kingdom, Canada, and United States. Now, what was the purpose? War bonds are debt securities issued by a government to finance military operations and other expenditure in times of war. They're also a means to control inflation by removing money from circulation from a stimulated wartime economy. As I mentioned in other videos, major wars are designed to reconfigure the current economy and have two purposes: monetary reset and depopulation. This is why wars must be controlled. However, World War II didn't quite work out the way it's supposed to. Nonetheless, war bonds served their purpose, the debt was kept under control, and the inflation, which started in the 30s, was back in the bottle. By the way, you know who made a ton of money off of war bonds? J.P. Morgan. Morgan played a prominent part in financing World War I. Following its outbreak, he made the first loan of $12 million to Russia. In 1915, a loan of $500 million was made to France and Britain following negotiations by the Anglo-French Financial Commission. Nowadays, however, a new war against SEO couldn't be controlled. Therefore, something else was needed. The 2020 disease bonds would spark discontent, so that trick wouldn't work either. Disease itself took out mostly old boomers, while vaccines will sterilize future generations. But the problem remains, what's to do with all the debt? The reason war bonds worked is because people were willing to spend money on them and the cost of reconstruction soaked up the debt. But now, there's no reconstruction to spend money on and there's no major wars. By the way, notice we keep hearing more about UFOs and aliens. These guys are getting ridiculously desperate. What's next, an alien invasion? At this point, nothing should be surprising. The only strategy left is monetary stimulus. Problem with that strategy is it'll do nothing but putting a band-aid on a gunshot wound. More money they print to cover the stimulus, the more inflation will rise. It's like putting out fire with gasoline, as David Bowie would say. What about cryptocurrency? Well, if you simply switch fiat currency to crypto, what you end up with is just a fiat crypto, and you have the same problem again. You could back it up with electricity, but what happens if there's a power shortage? War bonds help finance wars not against other countries, but rather against inflation. All sides benefited from them. It's not a coincidence that the gold was forbidden and confiscated in 1933 during economic depression. Neither is the fact that gold standard was abolished as soon as gold was allowed in free sale again. By the way, the gold standard was abolished on August 15, 1971. Exactly 3 months later, company Intel, with the help of Ted Hoff, introduced the first microprocessor, the Intel 4004, on November 15, 1971. What a coincidence. At some point, gold standard is going to be reinstated because the SEO will no longer tolerate fiat. Russia is buying gold, so is China. Even Hungary recently tripled its gold reserves. Russia holds the world's fourth largest foreign currency and gold reserves. The SEO is not stupid, Mafia. They know what they're doing. And so do we. Now, here's what we can expect. There'll be more stimulus packages, more push for vaccination, and more inflation. They'll be shorting gold and silver for a while to keep the dollar alive until it becomes too obvious that inflation is here to stay. Once it reaches the boiling point, the system will blame it all on 2020 disease, and the new monetary system will be introduced due to increased pressure from SEO. Don't know exactly when or by which means, but it's coming, and it's not far away, not at all. This fight is fought by money, and gold and silver are the only real money. Understand this, Black Pearl has more gold than central banks of Canada, Israel, and Germany, and you know why? Because they don't have any gold. That puts us in a very advantageous position. If you like this video, like it, download it, re-upload it, make it your own if you want to. You can also support this channel through PayPal tip jar, to which you find a link in the description box. This is Top Dollar signing off.